Have you heard the saying, hurt people hurt people? And you know what else is true? Hurt people often hurt the ones they love. As a pediatrician, I've seen children hurt in so many different ways by the adults who love and care for them. That's why I'm always talking to caregivers about ways to prevent childhood trauma. In my clinical practice, I screen for ACEs, or adverse childhood experiences, and I provide trauma-sensitive care. I also joined an amazing group called Creating a Resilient Community Network in Central Florida to help prevent and heal our community of trauma. As a facilitator, I give workshops on ACEs, resilience, and healing, and I even dedicated a chapter in my new positive parenting book, High Five Discipline, to raising awareness about ACEs and to ensure the way parents discipline is not a source of trauma for their kids. Now, when I encounter children who experience trauma and explore their family dynamics, I often see generations of adversity. Like Brian and his little sister, Sarah, at such a young age, they had already experienced their mother battling drug addiction, being in and out of foster care, and was now living with their maternal grandmother, who had her own share of past trauma. She strongly believed that what the kids needed when they were misbehaving was old school discipline. You know, spanking, yelling, and shaming. But nothing she did improved their behavior. Brian was in elementary school and already getting into fights, labeled hyperactive and disruptive in the classroom, and Grandma said he was a terror at home. In one particular incident, he almost set the house on fire. And Sarah, she had global developmental delays and behavior problems as well. She was 5, but behaved more like a 2-year-old. Right before my eyes, she babbled, whined, and hit to communicate her frustrations. And Grandma just hit her back on the bottom, not making the connection that what Sarah truly needed was love, patience, and guidance. You see, Brian and Sarah's story highlights how trauma can pass down through generations. Hurt people, hurt people. So I would like to talk to you today about how the 3 R's, recognize, build resilience, and restore, can help break the cycle of generational trauma. So we can start by asking, what happened to Brian and Sarah before they started acting out? So imagine with me just for a moment what had gone on in the midst of all of these traumatic experiences at a microscopic level. Well, their little bodies experienced prolonged, repeated trauma with very little nurturing and protective caregiving. And the science of childhood trauma tells us this created toxic stress, elevating the body's stress hormones like cortisol and damaging and dysregulating their brain and body systems, and even set the stage for Brian and Sarah to pass these dysfunctional processes on to their children. Now, we can explain some of this intergenerational transmission of trauma through epigenetics, or the study of how our behaviors and environments can create changes that alter the way our genes are expressed. Each one of our cells in our body contains genes, which houses our genetic code or blueprint for all of our functioning. And there are chemical switches above the genes that can turn on or off in response to the environment that create alterations affecting the way the genes work. And these alterations can pass on to the next generation. For example, we know certain moms who experience trauma have epigenetic changes called DNA methylation, which is associated with higher levels of depression and PTSD. And those same changes can show up in the child. And also, these moms may have maladaptive behaviors that creates an environment to further traumatize the child. These are biopsychosocial mechanisms that perpetuate trauma. Other epigenetic changes that researchers describe occur in glucocorticoid receptors, which regulate glucose and lipid metabolism, and also telomere length, responsible for cellular aging. In other words, toxic stress may lead to families with diabetes, high cholesterol, and even early death. So it makes sense that we heal and protect what happens to us so the long-term effects of toxic stress don't reach future generations. The good news is our brains can rewire, our bodies can heal, and epigenetic changes are reversible. We can have a positive impact on the way our genes work, and we can overcome adversity and create a bright future for generations to come. So how do we do it? Well, instead of passing down hurt, we need to pass down healing. And the three R's can help. Recognize, build resilience, and restore can help break the cycle of generational trauma. Recognize the symptoms of trauma you may be experiencing. Has something bad happened to you and you find yourself fearful, sad, numb, hopeless, or depressed? Are you experiencing panic, anxiety, finding yourself irritable or angry? Do you feel like you need something to take the edge off? Are you finding it difficult to complete the task at hand? Your focus is gone. Are you self-medicating your pain? Stop right there, because these are symptoms of trauma. Recognize and then ask for help. Finding a qualified mental health therapist can help address the symptoms of trauma. Therapists can provide trauma-focused interventions like child-parent psychotherapy or trauma-focused cognitive behavior therapy to help you manage your thoughts and feelings, change maladaptive patterns and practices, and develop positive coping skills. Also, eye movement desensitization reprocessing, or EMDR, can help to repair injury by helping the brain to focus and reprocess traumatic memories. And the second R is resilience. Resilience is simply the ability to overcome adversity. And you can build resilience by surrounding yourself with systems of support. This could be your family or friends or a significant other. It could be your therapist and a support group, or even your church family and your pastor or a coach or a teacher. Having healthy relationships can provide the safe, stable, nurturing connections and positive experiences your brain and body need to reset. Also, finding a sense of purpose and practicing gratitude can help. I like to share a personal story about how resilience works. As a child, I experienced various forms of trauma. But that's just a part of my story, because I had way more positive childhood experiences. I was raised by a village of people who loved and nurtured me. My Nana was and still is my favorite. I was an excellent student. I was very active in school, playing sports. I played in the band. I sang in the choir at church and at school. You see, having all of these healthy relationships, safe environments, and positive experiences helped me get through tough times and helped me heal. Now, that doesn't mean that the trauma didn't hurt and I don't remember it, but what it means is that I didn't break and I flourished through good and bad times. I owe my success as a pediatrician, wife, and mom to the gift of resilience. And the last R is restore. Restore the brain and body through healing practices. Pediatrician, ACE champion, and California's first Surgeon General, Dr. Nadine Burke-Harris, prescribes healing practices. She advises that we eat a well-balanced, healthy meal. Yes, drink plenty of water, eat lots of fruits and vegetables, but also get adequate amounts of sleep and regular exercise. I love her advice to practice mindfulness by getting out in nature. Take a walk, sit on a park bench and chat with a friend, and remember to breathe deeply. She also supports the value of healthy relationships and mental health intervention when needed. Recognize, build resilience, and restore. The three R's work together to regulate a dysfunctional stress response system and enhance the brain and body's healing powers. We all will experience something traumatic in life, and as much as we try to prevent it, children will experience adversity too. According to psychotherapist Kristen Langley Obaugh, we repeat what we don't repair. I'm asking you to repair today. You can break the cycle of trauma in your family. You can repair and pass down healing. And you can build up your next generation. Thank you.